Hello, welcome to a new Applied Time Series Analysis and Forecasting tutorial. My name is Juan Amico, I'm an economist, and in my channel I submit videos about macroeconometric forecasting, applied time series analysis, forecasting, and econometrics. So if these are topics that you are interested in, please feel free to subscribe to my channel so you can get a notification anytime I submit new content. Before we proceed, I would like to let you know that you can get access to the material following the link that is in the description. It's going to take you to this page where you can get all the files to produce all the results. I have memberships available, so there's two categories. There's one that is just to support the channel, just if you like the content and you would like to contribute on a monthly basis, it's only $1.99 a month. That would be great. That would really help my channel, as my videos are not funded by any external source. And at the same time, I have a different category, which is called more videos. And in this category, what you can do is get access to a couple of more examples or other type of content. In this case, these are the different videos where members can access to. I talked about DSGE oil models in Stata. I have done some simulations changing parameter values in the new Keynesian DSGE model. Understand the three equations, new Keynesian DSGE model in Dynar, we have calibrated this model. So in this tutorial, we're going to talk about business cycle properties. We're going to go through model validation. We're going to discuss the data, what we see in the real data versus what we get in the model. For this purpose, we're going to be looking at different statistical moments, deviation, correlation, etc. And I'm going to show you the commands to compute these comparisons. So to be able to understand then how we're going to be comparing the data with the model, we need to understand business cycles and we need to produce a graph like this one so we can see some things that we should find in our model as well. So the idea is that we see how the variables behave over the business cycles. In this case, the variables GDP, investment, consumption, hours worked, they have all been decomposed in cycle and trend using the HP filter. And we can see that investment is four times more volatile than GDP. So you can see here all the variables. You can see GDP is the blue line. You can see the orange is hours worked. You can see that this kind of, I think it's like a brown, is also following very close to GDP. But then we see that investment is really volatile compared to the GDP cycle. So normally what we find in data is that investment is between four and even four times and a half, sometimes more volatile than GDP. This is like a property of business cycles. Those are stylized facts. It's stuff that we're going to find in the data. And then consumptions and hours worked are less volatile than GDP. So what we see then is that over the evolution of GDP around the trend, yes, that's what the cycle is, we can see that consumptions and hours worked, this means labor, is not too volatile. It follows very closely GDP. And this is because these are very frictional variables. And when we see changes in GDP, normally consumption and labor follow through very closely to GDP. But now investments is a variable that is way more volatile than this. And we can see that big precipitation, we can see big changes when the economy is going through some booms or when it's going through recessions. We're going to see that investment does show whether because they are anticipating things, we are seeing that they are moving more aggressively over the cycles. So I just mentioned this then in the previous tutorials, we estimated the model, but how do we assess if it resembles a real economy? We're going to try to match moments of the data with the moments of the variables in the model. We're going to look at correlation and standard deviation. Ideally, the model can match the moments of the real data. What do we do if there are discrepancies? Well, we can always try to polish the calibration of the model, or if calibration is not good enough, then of course it can mean that we have some structural problems in our model. This is either other equations are not defined properly, maybe there's some problems with the derivations of the model, maybe with the with the identification of the model, there can be different things that can influence on why our model is not able to produce results that resemble the economy. But again, all these things are things to consider once we are done with comparing or matching moments of the data. So the idea then in this video is that I'm going to show you the commands to be able to produce this table that I have put in my paper. We have here data. It's showing here the standard deviation for GDP, consumption, investment, and hours worked. Then we have a ratio. We divide each of the variables by GDP, and we see the standard deviation relative to GDP. As I said before, consumption and hours worked are less volatile than GDP, but you can see that investment is 4.13 times more volatile than GDP. And then we can look at the correlation of these variables. We can see that they all have a positive correlation with GDP. When GDP expands, we'll see consumption, investment, hours worked, everything moving along. And then the idea is that we can look at how these moments compare to the real data. These are the moments that we are going to calculate from our model. We can see that the standard deviation of GDP is quite close. For consumption, it's not as close as the model, as the real data, sorry. But then we have investment is very close, and hours worked as well. Correlation, we see they are all positive. For some of the variables in our model, we can see that it's actually a bit more correlated than in the real data. But overall, I would say that things are quite well. If you find in your model that the standard deviation maybe for investment is very low, or that the ratio is not close to 4, then we have a problem, because as we saw in the data, I show you the graph, we should have that the correlation of these variables, the ratios of these variables follow along very closely, and that investment is 4 times more volatile at least than GDP. All right. In the notes, I provided some information from where the data is from, and of course, all these variables have been detrended using the HP filter. Where in Stata, I have split the screen into two, so here I can keep the table, we can look at the estimates, and here on the left, I have Stata, so we can calculate all these statistics. The idea is that you first run the model. Of course, these are all the variables that we have derived from the first tutorials. And the idea is that we're going to produce the standard deviations for the variables. We're going to type summarize, and we have GDP, consumption, investment, and hours worked. And here we get the standard deviation. You see it's almost 157, 139, 649, 0.83, and that's what we got here. The next thing that you have to do is to divide each of these standard deviations by GDP. So for example, I'm just going to show you, let's do consumption is 139, and we're going to divide it by 157. And here we get the value is 0.88, and that's what I wrote here. You're going to do the same for these variables. Let's just try one more just to show you. It's 649. The standard deviation, you're going to divide the standard deviation of investment with GDP. And here we get the value is 4.13. That's what I wrote here. That's perfect. Now, the last thing that we need to do is calculate the correlations. The correlations, you're going to type correlate. That's the command. And we're going to type the following now. GDP, consumption, investments, and hours worked. You're going to see here, you're going to find the correlation of each of these variables with respect to output. That's what we got here. There is the correlation of each variable with respect to output. For consumption is 0.88, investment 0.87. That's what you see here. And hours worked 0.75. That's what you see here. That's great. Now we have to look at how to get the results for our model, because these are the values for our data. For the model, all we have to do is to the following. We need the variance-covariance matrix to be able to obtain the standard deviation values. So let's type stat covariance. And this is, of course, a command that you need to run after you run the DSGE model. If you don't run your DSGE model, of course, you're not gonna get any results. All right. So you can see here we get the variance for consumption is 0.64, but we need a standard deviation. So we're gonna put square root. I think it's like this. The command. Let's see. 0.64. And we get that the standard deviation for consumption is 0.8, and here we got 0.8, all right? For GDP, the first variable, let's see, the standard deviation, here we have the variance of Y. So display square root, open parentheses, and we have to type 2.64. This is the variance, we need the deviation. And we get 1.62. That's the value that we have here, 1.62. You're gonna do the same with all of the variables, all right? You're gonna go find here the variance. Here you see, for example, the variance of investment. Display square root, we're gonna put here this value. And we get 6.59, and that's the value that you're gonna put in here. Now, the next step would be dividing, and you guys already know this. I'm just gonna do one just to remind you how to do it, but it's dividing the standard deviation of the variable X, in this case is consumption, with GDP. So let's go display, we're gonna divide then the standard deviation, which is 0.80, by 1.62, and you get 0.49, and that's the value that you get in here. Now, the last thing for the correlation, this one is going to be a bit more, well, it's not difficult, of course, but I'm saying we can't do like before a correlate command, because this is coming from our model. So remember that the correlation is the covariance divided the standard deviation of the variables that we want to find the correlation for. Let's suppose consumption. So we want to find the correlation between GDP and consumption. We're going to type display. I'm going to type here the covariance. Let's go find it. So we need the covariance between GDP and consumption. So here we have covariance between consumption and GDP. I'm going to grab this. It's 0.91 divided, open parentheses, and we need to multiply now the standard deviation of consumption. We have it here, 0.80. You already know how to calculate this, times the standard deviation of GDP, that is 1.62. Once you do that, you get a value of 0.70, and that's what we have here, 0.70. So that's the way that you're going to calculate the correlation. So, guys, we have covered then how to replicate this table. Now you know how to construct this table, how to build a table, and how to compare then whether the moments of your model are matching the moments of the real data. If that's the case, remember, your model is, I would say at least, is producing desirable results. Now, if your model is very far from the data, then of course you'll have to take a look at the calibration. For example, if you wanna improve consumption, you can play around with beta. If you wanna improve hours worked, maybe you can play around with gamma. If you wanna work around investment, you can play with the depreciation rate. If your capital depreciates faster, you're gonna need more investment, of course, because your capital is depreciating fast. So those are some things you can play around with. If this doesn't work, remember, you'll have to then focus on the equations that you set up in your model. There might be something wrong. And remember, please share, like the video. That's gonna really help me a lot. And remember, you can get the material for these tutorials. And remember about memberships as well. That's a great way to support my channel for those of you who, of course, can do it. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.